Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
You're watching South Asia Newsline, and here are the top stories we're tracking for you on Thursday, the 23rd of May. Campaign ends for sixth phase of India election as political parties make last-ditch efforts. World leaders bid farewell to Iran's President Raisi. And Sri Lanka to hold presidential election first, parliamentary polls later. And now for all the details. As the campaigning for the penultimate phase of India's general election ended on Thursday, political parties made last-ditch efforts to woo voters. Addressing a rally in Uttar Pradesh, Home Minister and BJP leader Amit Shah took a dig at opposition India Alliance and said in the five phases of election concluded so far, the bloc has been completely defeated. Shah said, while there is no possibility of the opposition alliance winning the election, people still want to know who will lead the coalition. Slamming the remarks of Congress leaders over Pakistan-occupied Jammu and Kashmir, Shah said, they have such a mindset that they are willing to give up the regions fearing atomic bomb of Islamabad. The atomic bomb can't resolve anything. Having a leader with atomic courage can only solve the disputes, he added.
ये विपक्ष एक घमंड या गठबंधन बनाकर आगे बढ़ा है. मैं आज यहां से राहुल बाबा को पूछना चाहता हूं, कोई संभावना नहीं है, दूर दूर तक नहीं है, मोदी जी ही प्रधानमंत्री बनने वाले हैं, मगर देश की जनता जानना चाहती है कि आपको अगर बहुमत मिलता है तो आपका प्रधानमंत्री कौन होगा.
Meanwhile, opposition Congress leader Rahul Gandhi in a rally in capital New Delhi hit out at the ruling BJP and said if Prime Minister Narendra Modi's party is elected for a third term, it will change the constitution. He said while BJP will remove reservation, Congress in its manifesto has promised it will remove the 50% cap on reservation. He alleged the Prime Minister works for only certain industrialists but pays no heed to the demands of the poor.
Ki sirf 22 logon ke liye kaam karte hain. Adani ji ke liye, Ambani ji ke liye, wo jo bhi chahte hain 2 minute mein Modi ji kar dete hain. Railway chahiye le lo. पोर्ट चाहिए ले लो, इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर ले लो, अगली भी स्कीम चाहिए चलो अगली भी स्कीम दे देते हैं, जो भी इनको चाहिए दे देते हैं. और गरीब जनता 24 घंटा हाथ जोड़ के कर्जा माफी मांगे, सड़क मांगे, अस्पताल मांगे, शिक्षा मांगे, नरेंद्र मोदी बस देखते रहते हैं.
The sixth phase of India's gigantic election will see 58 constituencies spread over 8 states and union territories going to polls on May 25th. These includes all seats of national capital Delhi, where BJP made a clean sweep in 2019 elections. The polls will conclude on 1st of June with counting scheduled for June 4th. Moving on. World leaders bid farewell to Iran's President Ibrahim Raisi and Foreign Minister Amir Abdullahian, who died in a helicopter crash this past weekend. India's Vice President Jagdeep Dhankar visited Iran on Wednesday and met the acting President Mohammad Mukhbar and conveyed condolences over the tragic incident. The funeral ceremony was also attended by representatives of Iran's proxies, including leaders of Hamas, Lebanon's Hezbollah, Yemen's Houthi, and a delegation of Taliban. Raisi was seen as a potential successor to Supreme Leader Ayatollah Ali Khamenei. He died at a time of worsening strains between the clerical leadership and wider society, aggravated by tightening political and social controls and a worsening economy. Presidential elections will be held in Iran on June 28th to replace Raisi. Moving on. Pakistan's jailed former Prime Minister and PTI party chief Imran Khan on Wednesday instructed supporters to wait for his call for street agitation following an attack on one of its leaders and Central Information Secretary Rauf Hasan earlier this week. Hasan, who was rugged up by a group of unidentified transgender individuals on Tuesday, received a gash on his face when one of the attackers wielded a blade against him while others knocked him to the ground. Khan, in a post on X, said his party was facing political persecution and no one would longer tolerate it. The PTI has described the incident as a bid on Hasan's life and accused the Islamabad police of tampering with the complaint by omitting the terrorism charge mentioned in it. Imran Khan said he had repeatedly said it was not possible to reach economic stability without first working for political stability in the crisis-hit country. Residents in Pakistan's financial capital, Karachi, are irked over frequent load shedding of electricity and gas while they are forced to pay hefty bills despite outages. A report.
Locals in Karachi, Pakistan's largest city, are irked due to frequent electricity and gas load shedding, especially amid the hot weather, while they continue to receive unusually high bills despite less consumption. This week, women and children in a locality disrupted traffic to raise the issue, but lamented the police did not let them to even protest. They said authorities are ignoring their pleas and this is injustice being meted on them. The protesters also raised concerns over rising inflation and blamed the government for its incompetent policies.
Sri Lankan President Ranil Wickremesinghe on Wednesday reiterated the island nation will witness presidential election this year ahead of the parliamentary elections. Local media outlet Daily Mirror reported that in a cabinet meeting held on Wednesday, Wickremesinghe emphasized that the presidential election should be held within the specified period this year in accordance with the constitution. While the Election Commission of Sri Lanka has announced the presidential poll will be conducted in the beginning of the last quarter of 2024, there were calls from both opposition and ruling lawmakers to hold general election first. The parliamentary polls in the island nation are due for 2025. However, constitutional provision allows the president to dissolve the parliament ahead of the due date and calls for early elections. Devout Buddhists in India's holy cities of Gaya and Varanasi on Thursday celebrated Vesak Day, honoring Lord Buddha's birth, enlightenment and death. Vesak Day, popularly known as Buddha Purnima in India, is celebrated annually on the full moon night of May. Scores of Buddhist monks from different countries took out a religious procession near the Bodh Gaya pilgrimage site, where he is believed to have achieved enlightenment, while devotees paid obeisance at the Sarnath in Varanasi, where he delivered his first sermon. They offered prayers and wished for world peace and well-being.
On this sacred day, we are praying for the world to be peaceful and also all living beings be happy, healthy, peaceful, long life.
Meanwhile, the Indian Embassy in Nepal also organized cultural and academic events on Wednesday in Lumbini, the birthplace of Lord Buddha. The events highlighted shared Buddhist heritage and traditions of India and Nepal and pondered upon Buddha's life and teachings. Nepal's Prime Minister Pushpa Kamal Dahal also graced the occasion and said culture occupies a special place in India and Nepal's bilateral relationship and such events strengthen the bond of both friendship and harmony. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.